By bringing the stars down to Earth and stripping the mystical veil off of Tarot,
we can now open a window into the self.
You are the magic. These are your tools.
Welcome to Self Mastery,
the practical art of tarot and astrology.
Welcome to Tarot in the Movies, another dive into the cinema's favorite characters and how they correlate into the major arcana. When we visualize the Emperor entering the scene, it's usually riding his chariot, storming through a cloud of dirt, entering the gates of his kingdom. The two-horsepower transportation was far away from the 1941 Lincoln Continental Coupe, which of course shuttled the Godfather. Come on, let's make an offer you can't refuse. That's right, the movie is the Godfather, and the card, the Emperor.
Vito Corleone, born Vito Andolini, is a fictional character in Mario Puzo's 1969 novel, The Godfather. So you ask, how does the Godfather relate to the Emperor? Well, that's why you're listening to our podcast, hopefully. We're glad you stayed. Vito's birthday was December 7th, 1891, making him a Sagittarius. And Marlon Brando, who played Vito, was an Aries, which is the sign of the Emperor card. You can't make this up, people.
To start, the Emperor card is the father archetype of the tarot deck and the number four of the major arcana cards. The Godfather often quoted,
"A man that doesn't spend time with his family can never be a real man."
And
never takes
Jordan speaking. All right, I'm going to try it.
Sorry.
Never take sides against the family ever.
Anyway, the card represents the highest leadership and symbolizes power, strength, and success. It often predicts that you will achieve that level of success. Well, as we all know, the Godfather reached all that and more, providing for his family and protecting and defending his loved ones, along with supporting the people of his community with service
and friendship.
Vito Andolini did not let his circumstances define him. In pure emperor energy, he received the name of his village, Corleone, at Ellis Island, and began his quest to rule his way. The emperor will not be subject to others' rules and regulations. The emperor, in short, is rebellious. And in true mobster style, the Don bypassed America's laws and made his own for his own kingdom.
I believe in America. America has made my fortune. And I raised my daughter in the American fashion. I gave her freedom, but I taught her never to dishonor her family.
The movie begins with Bonacera, a man seeking a favor. He explains that he always believed in America until his daughter was beaten. He explains that the American justice system failed to punish those men, and he realized then he needed to go to the Don. Don Corleone wants to know why Bonacera went to the cops first, then whispers, asking the Don to kill the man who attacked his daughter. Bonacera finally kisses the Godfather's hand and begs to be his friend. The Godfather agrees to make the attackers suffer as Bonacera's daughter suffered, but not murder them, in exchange for a future favor. The Don ruled with a firm and fair hand. He had a clear vision of what he wanted to create and organize those around him to manifest his goals.
They smiled at me. Then I said to my wife, "For justice, we must go to Don Corleone."
The emperor will listen to the advice of others, but he prefers to have the final say, as with the discussion with his son Sonny and Tom Hagen about the deal with Virgil Salazzo, the Turk. Hagen and Sonny think that the family needs to get in Salazzo's narcotics business because it is the thing of the future. The Don, however, after listening to their opinions, turns down Salazzo's offer, saying that drugs is a dirty business and it could cost him some valuable political connections.
He's known as a top narcotics man.
Santino, what do you think?
There's a lot of money in that white powder.
Huh?
Well, I say yes. There's more money potential in narcotics than anything else we're looking at. Now, if we don't get into it, somebody else will. one of the five families, maybe.
The Emperor, systematic, strategic, and highly organized in his approach, sticking to his plan until the end. The Emperor analyzes everything before they move.
I'm not interested in things that don't concern me,
said Don, Vito Corleone. The Don was not careless when building relationships with people connecting to individuals from all walks of life. His generosity meant that more people were willing to work with him, and he had greater armies of street soldiers, as well as greater connections inside law enforcement and the justice system.
I must say no to you, and I'll give you my reasons. It's true, I have a lot of friends in politics. But they wouldn't be friendly very long if they knew my business was drugs instead of gambling, which they regard as a harmless vice, but drugs is a dirty business.
Oh, Don Corleone.
It doesn't make any difference to me what a man does for a living, you understand?
Conflict doesn't scare the Emperor either, and he won't hesitate to use his power to protect those he cares about. And in return, those people will repay with loyalty and respect, hence the name Godfather. In this case, we can talk about the singer Johnny Fontaine, the godson to Don Corleone. Fontaine really wanted a role in an upcoming war film.
Corleone, Johnny's godfather. To the Italian people, that's a very religious, sacred, close relationship.
I respect that. Judge Tony should ask me anything else. But this is one favor I can't give him.
Don Corleone sends his new consigliere, Tom Hagen, to negotiate with Jack Waltz, the head of the studio. Don Corleone specifically tells Tom the iconic line, make him an offer he can't refuse. Waltz shows Hagen around Hollywood and shows him his prized racehorse, Khartoum.
You do appreciate beauty, don't you? There you are, $600,000 on four hooks. I'll bet Russian Tsars never paid that kind of dough for a single horse. Khartoum. Khartoum. I'm not going to race him, though. I'm going to put him out to stud.
However, he refuses to help out Fontaine, even resorting to belligerently shouting at Hagen, now you get the hell out of here. Hagen returns to New York and lets Don Corleone know what kind of response Waltz gave him. The next day, Waltz wakes up, only to find Khartoum's bloody head in bed with him. He shockingly then changes his mind on Fontaine, and the role in the film is his. And it does, in fact, win Fontaine an Academy Award. He understands the person, gathers all the necessary information, and then makes them an offer they can't refuse. Here's a story note. Yes, it was a real horse head used in that shot.
The Emperor card is the card of reason, which Don uses at the meeting of all the head bosses. Come, let us reason together, because I am a reasonable man. I can't do it. He creates calm out of chaos by breaking down any problem into its parts, then mapping out the actions needed to resolve it, thus ending the family's war. The Emperor may be a teacher, a coach, boss, or just a good friend who likes to take what they've learned and pass it on so that others could be as wise and powerful as them.
I hope that we could come here and reason together. And as a reasonable man, I'm willing to do whatever's necessary to find a peaceful solution to this problem.
Then we are agreed.
The Don encouraged the moving up in his ranks by offering tutelage from soldiers from the Capo Regime. And he also trained and counseled Michael Corleone to replace him, knowing he was going to retire. In conclusion, The Godfather encompasses all that the Emperor has to offer. And we couldn't use all the examples because this movie is really based on the Emperor anyway. So we have limited time. Integrity, capitalism, self-mastery, family, and secrets to power, leadership and success, and so on and so on. That's the Godfather.
The strength of the family, like the strength of an army, lies in its loyalty to each other.
That's what Don said anyway. The path is inside you, and it's always just beginning.
We are forever grateful to share in the exploration with you. We'll see you soon.
Thank you for listening to Self Mastery, the practical art of tarot and astrology.